is what I tell myself, so I could feel something else. Yeah, I guess I had my bad days, but it doesn't mean I lost my style. Where were you when my heart was on the ground? I thought time would prove that you would stick around. I guess time stops down, a king without his crown. Now I'm breaking, you're faking, girl, you never made a sound. If I never know, yeah, if you're gonna leave, I'ma let you go. I'm tired of the pain. Go away. I'm tired of the pain.
Oh, If I never know, yeah, if you're gonna leave, I'ma let you go. I'm tired of the pain. Go away. I'm tired of destiny. hide my bad days, but it doesn't mean I lost my style.
Darling, where were you when my heart was on the ground? I thought time would prove that you would stick around. I guess time starts down, a king without his crown. Now I'm breaking and you're faking, girl. You never made a sound.
Never know. Yeah, if you're gonna leave, I'ma let you go. I'm alone, I'm a broken home. I gave you all the bricks that I own and know. I'm letting go, I'm breaking these walls down, breaking these walls down. If you want adventure, then fly to home. But if you wanna travel, then go alone. Yeah, what's the point in us if I never know? Yeah, if you're gonna leave, I'ma let you go. I'm tired of the pain. Go away. I'm tired of destiny. Hotter. Doesn't mean I lost my style.
Where were you when my heart was on the ground? I thought time would prove that you would stick around. I guess time starts down, a king without his crown. Now I'm breaking, you're faking, girl. You never made a sound.
Never know. Yeah, if you're gonna leave, I'ma let you go.
I'm tired of the pain. Go away. I'm tired of destiny.
feel something else. Yeah, I guess I had my bad days, but it doesn't mean I lost my
darling. Where were you when my heart was on the ground? I thought time would prove that you would stick around. I guess time starts down, a king without his crown. Now I'm breaking, you're faking, girl. You never made a sound.
If I never know, yeah, if you're gonna leave, I'ma let you go.
I'm tired of the pain.
Finally, this isn't exactly how we planned to do this. We did have this live broadcast contingency plan in place for months. However, we didn't think we'd be using it because Armageddon was upon us. But here we are, and we are very excited. We are proud to have been able to work with the dance team this past year, especially with this documentary on their trip to Nationals. We had an amazing time. It was just a fun experience. But first, we were talking with the team in the group chat, and we've decided that we would actually like to show the first video I ever produced before the documentary. So this video, it's by my current standards, it is awful. It's weird and confusing, but here is the first video I ever produced, and we'll be back in just a moment with the actual documentary.
You know the bed feels warmer, sleeping here alone. You know I dream in color and do the things I want. You got the best of me, think you've had the last laugh, bet you think that everything good is gone. Think you left me broken down, think that I'll come running back. Baby, you don't know me cause you're dead wrong. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Stand a little taller, doesn't mean I'm lonely.
Well, I'm still not entirely sure what the hell that was. That it was also sort of a dance video. But now I won't keep you waiting any longer. We have our documentary ready to go. DHSDT, The Road to Nationals. This, again, we had so much fun producing this with the team. And of course, the team worked incredibly hard to show off that amazing performance they did at prelims and finals. And it's also been a lot of work to edit. Shooting it, staying up till 3 a.m., that was perfectly fine. It was just later on, we've had so many issues with our editing software, it's been really glitchy, but 8 attempts later, 10 and a half hours of rendering later, and here is DHSDT, The Road to Nationals.
Your eyes are open, so never close them. You'll sail the ocean fine.
This team is like our second family.
We're also very excited for this new experience.
It's going to be extremely bittersweet. It's going to be really tough.
You always bring something new, you know?
So we're so close, and I love them all very much.
It's a different feeling when you do other sports and you look at dance, because what is negative?
To drop this album, let's push it back another week. I wanna be next up forever, find a way to never hit my peak. I'm kinda scared of graduation, cause who am I when this is done? I wanna be next up forever.
Yeah.
No tricks, only choreo.
We gotta stay so much. You better.
And then drop back down to that.
Right now we're just working on perfecting the little details, because we practically have our whole routine done and we just want to make sure every little thing is perfect and like well put together.
Like, we're like to the point like this routine looks so good from where it was until like where it is now. Like I feel like it's like nationals is like so like close, and we're gonna be like early, and like when we get on that stage, like everything's gonna like come into place and like no one's gonna like see us coming.
It's a tight space, so we don't have all the room that we can use, and our like formations are very like spread out, so it makes things even harder, and it's harder to do like some of our tricks since we do like stunts and stuff, so it's pretty hard for that.
So practice leading up to nationals was really, really tough. I think this year, compared to last year, we probably put in even more hours, just because we didn't have any snow days leading up to NDA, so that gave us more time to practice. We also put in a lot more time into conditioning our bodies, strengthening, strength training, and also endurance training. I would say that the number of like squats and push-ups and planks and everything else that we do for strength training probably more than tripled the amount that we did last year. As far as our endurance training went, we were running almost like close to 10 miles a week for, you know, leading up to nationals. And just because we needed to be at our best, the routine that we had this year was probably one of our most physically demanding routines. So it was definitely very necessary for us to be in our best shape.
Yeah, but we're also very excited for this new experience, because this is something that we've never gotten to do before. Like, this is a huge competition, and we also get to travel and like go to Florida with all of like our like best friends. As like they've said, that our team is so close. So I'm really excited to get this experience in, and I'm obviously very nervous. I think all of us are. I think the whole team is. But like, yeah, we're all very excited.
We're all excited.
Yeah.
I think we're on a good road to nationals. We have a really awesome routine,
And it's just gonna get better. We're gonna add things, we're gonna fix things, so many things for nationals, and it's just gonna get better. And we also have amazing stunts and tricks that we normally don't have this early on in competition season, which is really awesome, so that gives me hope also.
I do believe that our team is ready for NDA. I think that this team, we have a big variety of like choreo and tricks, and so I feel like we're gonna bring something completely different to NDA this year that we've never ever done before.
For nationals this year, I'm definitely super excited because of how we did last year. I definitely wanna keep that up and keep our train going forward, try to get all the momentum we can going into nationals. On our last two competitions, we placed first, which is definitely a little head of steam, so I'm definitely super excited. I think we have a good routine. I think we're gonna do fairly well. But I gotta go so much bigger, so they can never shut me down. I'm kinda scared of graduation, cause who am I when this is done? I wanna be next to you. So the best is always yet to come. Someday they'll be talking about me. Right now they're just walking around. Be talking about me. Somebody help me. Somebody help me. Someday they'll be talking about me. Right now they're just walking around me. Someday they'll be talking about me. Somebody help me. Should I keep it light? Stay out of the fight. No one's gonna listen to me.
So the trip down there was a little different. I think that we're so used to going to a particular venue. For the past 9 years, we were going to Universal Studios. So I felt that it was definitely a different feeling just heading over to a completely different venue, not being able to like go by the things that we're used to seeing and doing, whether that be practice areas or just the things that we would normally experience. Definitely made me miss like the other venue a lot, just because we had so many memories as a team at the original venue. And, you know, having 9 years at the same place and knowing what to expect, like it is hard to like all of a sudden completely just, you know, change that. So like an 18
when you're doing music, can you guys like have that performance factor right now, like with your face and like your attitude, like work it. We do this tomorrow, okay?
Now it's going to be extremely bittersweet. It's gonna be really tough. I know I'm gonna cry, just because I feel like I don't know life without NDA right now, because that's everything that dance has been leading up to. Like every single year of high school, it's always dance has led up to NDA, and it's gonna be a lot of pressure going off of last year, attempting to maintain our national champion title. But it's gonna be, I think, I'm confident in our abilities, but emotionally it's gonna be tough.
So at nationals, usually what we did freshman year and the years before that, they would have a park day, and then they would go towards practicing for prelims, and then they'd go into prelims, and then hopefully finals, and then another park day at the end. But last year, we changed it around a little bit, and we started off practicing, and we started off preparing for prelims, and then we were in that like hardworking mindset. So I feel like with that mindset, we were able to work our butts off until we were able to get to prelims and get to finals and then win. And then even after winning, we were on that high. So going to the parks right afterwards as like a winning team and as like a team that bonded over winning as well was just such an amazing thing to do.
When you guys go 1, 2, 3, 4, there's a little pause and then it goes.
Where we go out to fancy night, where we dress up, look nice, and we just spend the night together. Win or lose, we're just there for each other.
So, fancy night this year ended up being, I think it was like a ballroom downstairs from the front lobby. So it was different from what we're normally used to, because fancy night in the past would be at the Hard Rock Cafe. Which was next to the Hard Rock Live, which was the original venue. So this year, it was definitely fun just having like a chance to like dress up with the team. But it definitely also made me miss like having our usual fancy night dinner at the Hard Rock Cafe.
I get up, I get down, and I'm jumping around. And the rumpus and ruckus are comfortable now. Been a hell of a ride, but I'm thinking it's time to grow.
So we're just kind of feeding off of each other's energy, but I know, like, you know, sometimes you can see that and then you get discouraged. You're like, oh my god, like, that's intimidating, right?
That's but, not an option anymore.
But you guys,
we're here already.
See that, and you guys are letting that, like, bring in even more energy and more fierceness into what you guys are doing.
So, I think I'm feeling pretty good. Right now we're at 11 p.m. and we've been practicing all day long. But, you know, we've made a lot of good improvements throughout today, especially on the practice floor earlier today. The team looked really strong. I think they feel really confident. You know, tricks we're hitting and just, you know, overall intensity, synchronicity, everything was like, I felt really on point. So right now it's just a matter of just how much they, you know, want to push. And, you know, as long as they want to push, we're going to push with them. So, yeah.
1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Do it in place for now.
I think right now we're definitely in, you know, a good position to do well in prelims. I don't see anything that's causing me like or making me feel like any concern about prelims, but it's really tough. We always want to go in just trying our best. We don't want to, you know, assume that we will do well. It's just, we know, like, we've been training for this, we put in the work, and the best we can do is just, you know, control what we can't control, which is our own routine. And as long as they're confident in their own routine, they're confident on with each other and their teammates, then I think we're gonna do well. So
let's go out with the bang. Waking up after our first day at NDA, I was definitely very excited. I think that with the amount of time that we put into practices, I felt that we were ready. For me, I think that with that excitement also came with nerves, just like any other competition. No matter how prepared you are, I feel like you're always gonna feel that nervous energy. But if anything, I think that the team did a really good job. It was really nice just kind of feeding off of each other's energy, even though some of us were more nervous than others.
Text and she wants me to read it to you guys. Oh my God, it's prelims day! I can't believe the time is here and you have all worked so hard to get to this point. I have no doubt that you will all kill it on stage and leave the judges speechless. You guys are amazing and always keep your heads up. The only piece of advice I have is to leave everything on the stage and love every second of it. I'm y'all's biggest fan and I'm rooting for you more than anything. The work is worth it. DHSDT for life. Kill it.
Cause my taxes are due. Do my password begin with a one or a two? Been a hell of a ride, but I'm thinking it's time to grow. Metronome. Man, I'm up to something. Ooty-la-dee-do, thank you all for coming. I hope you like the show, cause it's on a budget. So ooty-la-dee-do.
Okay, so I think a lot of people, based off of pictures and things that you see like on social media and everything, it's easy to believe that Dance Team goes to nationals and it's more of a vacation and a trip, but it's definitely 99% practicing, and it's hard work, and it's sweating, and it is being exhausted. And the night before finals, we actually stayed up until about 2 a.m. outside in a random parking lot, and we were practicing for a solid 5 or 6 hours. And even though in the grand scheme of things that sounds like so much, but it's also so worth it when it all pays off in the end. And you never know what's gonna happen, so all you can do is prepare as best as you can. And we really did that this past year.
5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, 8.
Yeah, you guys are standing completely. You just popped up. Cause you dropped back down on
3, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Don't forget all the details. 3 and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Try again. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Move. 5, 6, 7, 8.
So practices leading up to our first performance, I would say that they went really well, just because I feel that our leadership group this year, they've done such a good job with just keeping the team together. And not having Claire there with me, you know, I think that it was more apparent how much like we needed our leadership group to just be strong for the team, and just to help, you know, keep things running smoothly, keep everybody's spirit high, just keep everybody, you know, calm and focused.
So put your best face on, everybody pretend you know this song, everybody come hang, let's go out with a bang.
This is an open hand. I swear to God, if I have to tell y'all open hand again, open hand is expanding all of your fingers. This is not an open hand. This is a lazy hand. This is an open hand. There's a difference. Okay? Freshmen, I'm mainly saying this to you because I've told y'all multiple times. This is an open hand.
All right. Bases for the pyramid. So the flyers are gonna go up, bang down, flip, and reverse it. You guys keep your hands on there, and then as soon as you hear the rewind, you guys let go, okay?
You guys right now, the energy you're bringing, like nobody's holding back wherever they are in this routine. And you guys, like you guys are selling it and you're not even facing me. I'm watching this routine from behind and it looks really good.
Yeah.
You've never performed before. You don't get another chance, okay? This is your one time. Kill it. You guys deserve to kill it, okay?
Let's go, guys!
So you act dumb like, duh. So you act dumb like, duh. Ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta. Check me so good, I say. Let me work it. I put my thing down, flipping in reverse. It's your feminism is staying there with me. It's your feminism is staying there with me.
After we had performed prelims, I remember us being led over to another room where we were able to review our footage, and they had somebody to do vocal critiques for us. And you know, when we were going through our footage, I felt really good. I felt really good about our prelims performance. But also, I think that we were able to see a lot of our nerves. I could tell that the nerves were getting to some of our dancers, and we were not as clean, or we didn't execute as well as we were on the practice floor right beforehand. And so those things were definitely apparent after our prelims performance. You know, one of the judges that I remember that gave us critiques was talking about, you know, our uniformity, our tricks not hitting the way that it should have hit. Things that I think we could see from just watching our routine footage. So a lot of the things that the judges were saying made a lot of sense. Maybe also the way that we had performed some of our visuals and just like choreography. There was just something kind of missing from maybe just the way that it was not only executed, but just the way that it was performed. A lot of things that I think we knew that we could take and work on. Overall, being in prelims at, I think it was sixth place in prelims. The team had really high expectations beforehand, but you know, we knew going into it, whatever we were gonna place, we did everything we could to make sure like we had a chance to move on to finals.
I've been so good, I've been helpful and friendly. I've been so good, why am I feeling empty? I've been so good, I've been so good this year.
Hey, hey, hey!
I would say one of our greatest strengths would be our positivity. We're always hyping each other up, each other going, and we're just there for each other. That's pretty great. And I would say weakness would be like before we get distracted a lot, but we always find a way to push through.
'As an officer, I think there's a lot of things that happen behind the scenes that a lot of people don't realize that go on. But from our perspective, especially with our nationals routine, we think about every single little detail. Everything that you see on the stage, we have at least thought about 100 times. And we just have to figure out, formation-wise, like to get an even mix of who's in the front and in the back. We have to make transitions seamless. We have to make visuals appealing. And we have to make sure the tricks go smoothly. So there's a lot of things that require a lot of work. And I'm really proud of this team of officers because we have killed it this year. And we work really hard and we put our team first, which is the most important.
The practice after prelims, I think I remember we took a break to just get some food, just to, you know, decompress for a little bit. But we regrouped like probably not even an hour after we left that floor. For us, we knew that there was another chance that we had. Making it to finals was our first step, but from there, like, we knew that we had another chance to, like, make this even better. I think that things were a little tough because with a team that's half vets and half rookies, there's a lot of pressure that was put on the rookies just because, you know, they know the standard was set so high from the year before and they didn't want to disappoint the rest of the team. And so I think after leaving the prelims floor, it was only natural, I think, to start having doubts in your mind, just to feel like unsure about finals. But I remember we did regroup and we had this talk before we started practicing. It was a pretty, I would say, emotional, like, meeting with the team, just because I think that everybody felt that they could have done more.
So right now, just go ahead and head back. We'll text out more details.
There's a little timing issues right now, but it's because we just did it, right? So if we work on this and get this down, it's going to look really good.
I think being a guy on a predominantly female team is a lot of fun because it just gives us so many like opportunities to like have like, because we get looked at a lot more, which can be kind of scary, but at the same time it can be like really cool because when we have our own little guys part, everyone like usually goes crazy, so we can usually make really fun, playful like choreography that like really goes along with like the crowd, and everyone's like, oh, the boys are gonna come, they're gonna get really hype. So I think it just gives us more of a chance to like really like show off our talent and also just bring a little extra like flair to the routine.
I think I faced a couple of challenges because definitely like when we go to camp, we're the only team that has guys. But while it's super fun, there is like a lot of pressure just being one of four guys, like, that's it. And it's kind of a predominantly hip hop. And then when we start to go into the contemporary and the lyrical, it definitely gets a little difficult because we're not really used to that. Even if you were a girl, it's kind of easier, I would say, but there's definitely a little bit of pressure being one of four guys.
During school, people ask me, are all the guys on the team gay or something like that, just because they think that when guys do dance, they're gay. I feel like also one of the adversities for me is also flexibility, because at training camp, at training camp, when we do warm-ups and everyone else is doing stretches, I can't do splits. Come outside, you fell, but now you're high. You've been outside, so go ahead and do it one more time. Come outside, you went hard and you did fine. You've been outside, so go ahead and do it one more time.
So I remember going to the practice floor right before finals, walking in there and running through our tricks, running through, you know, our routine. I felt the overall feeling is that the team felt confident. You know, they were hitting their tricks, they were hitting pretty much everything that we had changed and thrown at them the night before.
I just want to say I'm so proud of you guys. Like, it looks so good. Like, you guys killed it.
Don't make us cry.
Thank you. Like, I needed that. Every single one of you guys, keep it up.
You know, leaving the practice floor, going backstage, I think any time there's like room to breathe or room to like take a second, those times can sometimes be maybe of a disadvantage, because when you're not doing something or you're just kind of waiting, I think in those moments, like, that's a true test of whether like your mind's gonna, you know, be your friend or your enemy. They want it, 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 heaven for me. I gave them hell.
So you act dumb like, duh. So you act dumb like, duh. Ta 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 ta. Check me so good, I say. Is it worth it? Let me work it. I put my kind down, flip it in reverse. If your feminine stay here with the, if your feminine stay here with the.
Yetis like me, haters wanna fight me. Yetis mad cause I came up overnight. Me, yeah, I switched it up, I got a 9-cup tight. Me, so you better do the right.
I can't go off. Here's Sally Walker walking down the street. She didn't know what to do, so she jumped in front of me. I said, gone, girl, do your thing, do your thing, do your thing. Gone, girl, do your thing, stop. Do your thing, drop, lock.
Give it up,
Yo te pongo loca, look at this. Tipo así.
Bola,
so yeah. performing at finals, I would say that one of the things that I always remind everybody as a coach is to leave everything on that floor. You don't want to perform where you're going to look back at it and wish you could have done more. And I think that was really how I felt our finals performance went, that the amount of just energy that was on that stage, the amount of energy that the dancers gave out, just everything that was hitting, like, I truly felt that we, as a team, did everything we could. Like, we literally just left everything on that floor, and we couldn't have done any more. Come outside, you went hard, and you did fight. You've been outside, so go ahead and do it one time.
In fifth place with an 89.67, Dominion High School!
But happy for you guys, because I know how much you worked for that, okay? So you go home and you are proud of that fifth place that you bought that for Dominion. So thank you guys so much.
So it's always tough every year to like lose our dancers, and you know, we had three seniors this year. Two of them have been with us all 4 years. The other one was with us for three. And there's so many memories that they've made on this team, and just seeing their journey from, you know, their first year to their senior year, like, I'm so proud of everything they've done. On top of that, you know, Connor, leaving this year, which we were blessed to just have him for one more year. He's also going to be truly missed, and for him, he had to leave on a flight 5 a.m. the next morning after, you know, everything had ended. So for me, that made it hit even harder. It's always hard for me as a coach to like lose people, whether it's from graduation or just, you know, if they decide to leave the team. And so I know it's going to hit me harder as it gets closer to its end of the school year, but I think NDA is one of those events where we look forward to so much, like from beginning of the year, that it kind of feels like the end of our season. So I remember being at NDA, and then when we had our moment to kind of reflect back on the weekend, we definitely had an emotional moment.
I'm definitely gonna come back and visit whenever I can, just to keep in touch with my roots and where I came from and where this all started. But I do plan on going to VCU Arts College and hopefully joining Blank Canvas, their hip hop dance team over there. So, yeah.
My plans after My plans after high school. Well, I'm gonna do NOAA for 2 years, and then hopefully get into Virginia Tech. That's like what I'm aiming for, and then be a part of their dance team called Bamboom. So while I'm at Nova for 2 years, I will definitely be here a lot, like visiting every competition, supporting as much as I can. And I was like literally thinking like a couple minutes ago, like, what am I gonna do? Like, my life revolved around dancing so much. Like, everything was dance, school, dance, school, dance, school. Like, there was nothing else. And I don't know what I'm gonna do, and I'm gonna miss them a lot, so yeah.
My plans after high school are Nova for 2 years, and I'm looking towards George Mason or Virginia Tech. I as well wanna join Bamboo at Virginia Tech. But while I'm at Nova, I'm definitely gonna be back with Sarah, watching them at every competition, football game.
Oh God!
No, run away!
What threw them off before is that so now it's
just... I don't want to be in it!
Do you have Barbie in the Pro Princess?
Are you marrying me?
Yes.
Mr. K for newlyweds!
Catch my breath, let me catch my. I can't remember how I got here. Can you wait a sec? Let me catch my breath, let me catch my. I can't remember how I got here, got here. They wanted heaven from me, I gave them hell. Now they want something bigger, I'm overwhelmed. I think it's time to go now. I think my curtain's falling. Just don't forget about me when you get out of college.
But now we are going to get onto the section where we will be allowing members of the team to call in. And there is a delay in the broadcast. What you're watching is a few seconds behind me actually speaking. So for people to call in, just be aware of that. And also, we will call you, so please don't call us. It just makes everything easier. We have a list of everyone we're going to call in, what order we want to do it. So just let us call us. And also, when we do call you... please mute your TV or whatever. If you have the broadcast running on a second device other than the one you're calling in on, please mute that device. You don't need to turn the TV off or anything. Just mute it because otherwise it's going to create a feedback loop, which will sound sort of like if you've ever been in an auditorium and then someone turns the microphone on, there's like this high-pitched ringing sound that like blows everyone's eardrums. If you don't turn off or if you don't mute the broadcast when you call in, that will happen for everyone who's watching the broadcast. So please just mute the broadcast is all we ask. Okay, so our first caller is going to be Mr. K. I'm going to call him right now. Okay, we're gonna move to our next caller real quick. Who is Ashley? So let's go. Hello? Hi, 1 second, let me just connect you into the broadcast. So what was your reaction to the video?
I liked it a lot. It was, like, kind of cool because, like, usually, like, everyone gets to see, like, what we see, like, when we go to NDA. Like, everyone thinks, like, obviously in the pictures. Like, we take a lot of pictures and it's like, oh, it's, like, we're having a lot of fun. But, like, you get to see, like, how much we practice.
Hello?
Yeah.
Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay, continue.
Okay, so it's just, like, it's really crazy because, like, you know, like, this year it's a lot. We practice a lot. And so, like, I think by the end of it, like, the outcome, like, getting fifth place is, like, still amazing because, like, you, like, some people didn't even make it to finals. So then now, like, we made finals and we got, like, to the top five is amazing. And, like, it's a good end to the year, for sure.
So is there anything else?
No. Okay. Just, like, yeah.
Okay, well, thank you. I'm going to move on to the next caller now.
Okay.
All right, so I should have Mr. K on the line now. Hello? Hi, 1 second.
Hello?
Hi. I'm on the broadcast now.
Okay. How's it going?
Wait,
good. Hold on. Okay. Sorry about that. Was I supposed to call just now, or I think?
No, I was gonna. I called you. I have like a list of people over here.
Okay, cool. Sorry about that. It's just like it wasn't giving me a choice to answer any calls earlier, so.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Okay, wait, hold on. Now I can see myself, but we're just trying to get in the camera. Okay.
Yeah.
So I have Sky here that bumped her head. She was so excited watching
the
video, and then she ran into the island and then like hit the corner of the island, and now she but just wanted to say, like, that was so good. Like, thank you so much for, you know, spending the countless amount of hours like putting that together. It's like just crazy. Like, it feels like we just, you know, or I just left, you know, like a few days ago, you know. And you know, just like getting to see everything again, you know, just brings back so many memories. But I think one thing I just gotta get used to is just seeing myself so much on video. I try to avoid being on camera as much as possible. So yeah, but thank you so much, Kevin.
Yeah, no problem. Is there anything else you want to add?
I would just say, like, you know, after watching that, you know, like, it just reminds me of, like, how much this team, like, means to us, you know? Like, just because to spend that much time together in the whole school year and, like, having, like, each other and fighting for, like, you know, the same goal and like all of us putting, you know, just being all in on everything that we do. Like, you know, I couldn't have asked for a better season. And, you know, we're so proud of each and every one of you guys, like, that literally just made so many sacrifices. Like, sacrificing the time that you spend, like, after school, because obviously we, like, practice a lot. And, you know, the amount of countless hours you guys put into our leadership group, like, Mr. A, like, you know, especially not having Claire there was so tough, and having, like, you know, Betsa and Josh and, like, you know, just, like, in our leadership group and just, like, everybody working so well together that weekend, like, was such amazing, like, such an amazing experience, you know. And, you know, I truly believe that after we left that floor in finals, like, there couldn't have been any more that we could have done. We literally just poured our hearts out on that floor, and you know,
just very evident.
You can see, I mean you saw it,
I saw it from home. Obviously, it was our first time, my first time watching it from home, and it was super unexpected. You know, the morning of, that we weren't going to be able to go, but I had every confidence in the leadership that was going, and Mr. A, Mr. K, you know, I knew they were going to do fantastic.
Oh. Sorry. Oven.
Oh, sorry. Okay. Yeah, so other than that, you know, just thanks again. I mean, like obviously for our seniors that won't get a chance to, like, you know, continue, like, with practices and all the end of the year stuff that we normally do, which we're so sad about.
Yeah.
To, like, have this memory, like, recorded and documented. It's just so meaningful, you know, like, from the very beginning, like, when you came on to help us, I was just, like, thinking, like, okay, you know, we'll have, like, an extra hand to help out with, like, some pictures and video and stuff like that, but I had no idea, like, you know, what it was going to turn out or turn into. And, you know, like, just your attention to detail and, like, everything you do, like, is just so appreciated. Like, we appreciate so much. Like, you don't just do a job. Like, you, I mean, we could tell, like, you're passionate about it. Like, it looks so good. Like, everything you put together, the way that you edit everything, like, just thank you. You know, we can't be.
And I want to thank you too, Kevin, because I was missing so much this season. And I think I said it before, but your videos and especially this documentary really let me feel like I was there, really let me see, like, the whole weekend. And, you know, obviously I can't say I didn't miss out, but I've definitely had so much FOMO the entire time I was home. I missed everybody. I missed you guys, the team. But so like this documentary like means a lot to me personally because I really got to be there with them and like do the whole experience, you know, just in a different way. Thank you so much.
Yeah, no problem.
Thank you.
Okay, so I'm going to move on to the next caller now, which should be Mr. A. Okay, so I'm going to move on to our next caller, Mahika, for the moment. Hello? Hello? Hi, so let me just, are you on your phone or your laptop? Okay. Okay. So I guess, what was your, feelings or response to the documentary?
I really enjoyed that video a lot because you really depicted what we do at Nationals really well, like what goes on at practice and what really goes on behind the scenes, because a lot of the times people just see our performance and like the 2 minutes that we're on our stage, but they don't really see how much time and like how much dedication we put into our performances. So I think you did a really good job at that, and I really enjoyed looking back at all the fun moments we had at Nationals, and it really made me like miss our practices because of like the whole corona outbreak, and we don't have school, so we can't have our practices. But I really miss that, so thank you. I really appreciated this.
So how have things been since the like shutdown for you?
When the announcement was made that the rest of the school year was going to be canceled, I know a lot of people would be like happy about it, but I was really sad because I knew that we weren't going to have practice for the rest of the year. And I was also looking forward to things like the lock-in and like our end of the year workshops that we have. And then also spring pep rally. I was really looking forward to that because that was our time to show our NDA routine, but also add on pieces that choreographers in the team have made. And that's one of my favorite pep rallies. And also, our lock-in, which I was really looking forward to because that's always really fun just to be with the team and have no stress and team and everything.
Yeah. Is there anything else you'd like to add?
No, that's it.
Okay. Thank you for calling.
Thank you.
Okay. So we will move on to our next caller. Mr. A is unavailable at the moment. Tatiana. Okay. Hello? Hi, give me just 1 second. Sorry, it's like huge. Okay. All right. So what was your reaction to the video?
So I really liked the video. Putting all the effort that you put in, it made me realize how much I missed being an NDA, and it's so sad how the season has now come to an end. But watching all like the practices we've been doing and all that, I just really want to say like thank you for always being there, for always like watching the videos, and I just want to say that like I don't know, I just the video really made me emotional because like not like like finding out like you know I can't talk. So I just want to say, like, I like how you added all the videos of us practicing because, like, because I like, oh, my God, I can't talk.
It's okay.
No, overall, I just want to say thank you, and I really enjoyed watching the video, and yeah.
So how have you been doing since the, like, shutdown?
I've been bored. But it's made me sad how we can't go to practice anymore because I really miss everyone on the team and the coaches. And dance is like one of the biggest things in my life because it's always been dance in school. And like now that dance is not there, it's just kind of like I have nothing else to do. So, yeah.
Is there anything else you'd like to add?
No, I think I'm good. Thank okay. you.
Thank you for calling in.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so our next caller is Romy. Let's go. Hello? Okay, so what was your response to the documentary?
Oh my God, I literally loved it so much. Like, the work that you do for the team, it's amazing. And, like, everything about it is so cool. Like, the behind the scenes, just, like, how everyone can see what we do and how hard we practice and how, like, hard work pays off. Like, that fifth place, like, I know that everyone was so proud of it afterwards. And, like, it was so worth it in the end. And, like, I love how you showed that in the video. And it just showed all our memories. So, it was really nice.
Thank you. So, how have things been for you since the COVID-19 shutdown?
I'm really bored. And I'm also really sad because I miss everyone so much. Like, hi, everyone. I miss you guys so much. And, you know, I'm really upset that a lot of things got canceled, like practices and like big stuff, like the lock-in. I was so excited for that because everyone got so much closer and, you know. We're hanging in there and hopefully stuff will get better along the way.
Is there anything you'd like to add?
I just want to say thank you so much for everything that you do for dance team. Like, really, it's so meaningful. Like, I send your videos to, like, so many of my, like, family, friends, and, like, friends out of dance, and they love your videos so much.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay, well, thank you for calling in.
Thank you.
So our next caller is Ida. Hello? Hello? Hi. So what was your response? Yeah.
Wait, can you say that again? Sorry, okay. I can't hear you.
So what was your response to the video?
Just like all the hard work you put into it. Just like it made me like I feel like I relived every moment, and like I just miss Florida, and I wish I can go back, but I can't because I'm quarantined in my house. But honestly, it just made me like remember everything and like all the moments we had, and just like all the fun we had, and all the practices and hard work we put the whole team put together, and yeah.
Oh, did you see it? Just as I don't know why it just occurred to me. Did you see that a Dulles TSA worker recently tested positive for the coronavirus?
Oh, wow. I haven't heard of that, but I've heard of like a bunch of other cases that have been going around. Yeah.
Yeah. Which concerns me a little bit because I haven't seen for sure, but like he might have been on it's a like small chance, but
I mean, like, we got like warnings and everything, but like I know we had like some precautions. We all brought our face masks and stuff, but yeah, I know it's crazy. Like after we came back and like everything got so serious. Like, I know we went to school for a day.
Yeah.
Like, everything got canceled. And I was so surprised because I was, like, I was so excited to go back and, like, you know, see my friends and, you know, show this school, like, what we were going to do for, like, pep rally.
Yeah.
And it just makes me kind of miss it. So, yeah.
Is there anything else you'd like to add?
No, that's it. I just want to say thank you so much for the video, and hi DHSDT. I love you guys all. And
okay.
Goodbye. Bye.
Okay. So our next caller is Bianca. Hello? Hi, one second. Okay. So what was your response to it?
Well, I really enjoyed the video. Like, me and my parents, we had it on our TV, and my dad was just like, oh my god, this is so good. And like, I like how you like captivated like the whole thing. Like, you showed what the team does, like, behind the scenes and during practice, and like how like finals go. Like, we're all emotional and we also goof off a lot. So I really enjoyed the video.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
So how have you been feeling since everything shut down?
So I've been really bored. I really miss the team. Like, I, like, sometimes we took it for granted, like, when we were in practices. But, like, now, oh, my God, like, I miss everything. I miss practices. I miss the whole team. So, yeah.
is there anything else you'd like to add?
You did an amazing
Thank
job
you.
On the video. Like, loved it. Okay, that's okay. it.
Thank you for calling.
You're welcome. Bye-bye.
Okay. So our next caller, one second. One second. Nope. Okay. Okay, we're gonna move on to our next caller. And that is Eleni. Oh, here we go. Hello? Yeah. Not at the moment.
There we go. Does that work?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. So what was your response to the video?
I loved the video. First off, thank you so much for everything you've done. You really, like everyone has said it already, but you really captured every single aspect of that whole trip and more, especially with like the way you use the music too. It was like dramatic at points and you really like showed how we have like different sides of it. So I was really excited about that. And then also, I liked how you showed our like goofy side, like at the end, how you put like our little crackhead hour moment.
Mm-hmm.
That was really fun. I liked that a lot. Let's see what else. Just made me really miss it all.
Yeah.
And I feel like watching that over again, I was like reliving every single moment and it made me so happy. So thank you so much. I loved it.
Yeah. So how have you been feeling since everything shut down?
It is really sad, but I feel like a big thing that's made me realize is that family is really important. So I've been spending a lot more time with my family and just like enjoying that. And just like not taking that for granted, just like taking a step and like taking this moment to like slow down with my life and like really like schedule out what I need to do, because there's still like homework and then like things are like catch up soon enough. Yeah. So I'm definitely using that for granted. I mean, not going to use that for granted.
Yeah.
How are you doing with all this going on?
I've mostly been really bored, and I have also definitely missed the team a lot. Just had so much fun in NDA, and then now it's like everyone is separated, so
yeah, I really miss those moments, like everyone was saying, with like the lock-in and pep rally. And I was like hoping with that for like SDA, we were like helping out and trying to figure out when we're going to do that. So all of those moments, just like cutting it short is really sad. But I know soon enough we'll like get back into it, hopefully. So I'm just staying positive and hoping for the best.
Yeah. I know for me, the biggest issue is now, like, I was planning on the spring was going to be all lacrosse stuff after this, but obviously that's canceled, so now I don't know what I'm going to put up on my channel for the next, like, 3 months.
You could still, like, document yourself, you know, do something interesting. Figure something out.
Yeah. is there anything else you'd like to add?
Just a huge thank you, and shout out to everyone watching this. Everyone stay positive. And let's just hope for the best. We can only pray and hope for the best.
Okay. Thank you for calling.
All right. Thank you for having me.
Bye. Okay. So our next caller is Sophie. Hello? Hello? Hey, are you calling from a phone or a computer? Okay. Okay. What was your response to the video?
You did a really good job of capturing all of the amazing moments that happened at Nationals and showing all the hard work we put into the routine, because as some other people have stated, I think from the pictures that have got posted, people think the Nationals is more of a vacation, mm-hmm. but it's like a work trip in some yeah. ways, but I think you did an amazing job of capturing everything. So it was just so
Thank
good.
Thank you. How have you been holding up with the COVID-19 shutdown?
I've been really bored, and I just miss everyone, but I've been catching up on, like, schoolwork mm-hmm. and just relaxing, kind of, like, winding down from Nationals because it was a lot. But I do miss everyone yeah. so much, and I miss seeing our team and going to practice every day. And I'm really going to miss, like, doing spring pep rally and doing, like, the lock-in and the workshops leading up to, like, auditions for next season.
Yeah. I guess, is there anything else you'd like to add?
Just that I miss everyone and that you did an amazing job and that you're so talented. And thank you for capturing all of these great moments from this season. And I just miss all of you guys.
Okay, thank you for calling.
Thank you.
Okay, so our next caller is Rhea. Hello. Hi. Do you have the broadcast on in the background? Oh, okay, thank you. All right. I see you.
Well, wait here. Yeah.
Okay, there we go. So what was your response to the video?
Oh my god, I loved it so much. It was so good. It made me really miss a lot of the moments, and I don't know, it's just like, oh, I miss it so much, and it's just so sad that, like, now I can't see the team for a while. So yeah.
So how are you holding up with everything being shut down now?
Honestly, like, what's it called? It's been peaceful at the same time it's like, it's just so sad not seeing the people that you used to see every yeah. day, and then now it's just like you're by yourself, mm-hmm. kind of. But at the same time, it's peaceful, so it's not all bad.
Is there anything else you'd like to add?
I know everyone's saying thank you, but thank you so much, because, like, that was a lot of footage you had, and it was just really well executed, and you did amazing, and... hello to anyone who's watching this. I love you and miss you, and that's it. So,
well, thank you for calling.
Thank you.
All right, our next caller is Connor from Texas. So let's go Skype. Hello? Hi. Okay. So what was your response to the video?
Oh my god, Kevin, my response to your video was amazing. You had, like, my entire family in tears after that video, man.
Thank you. So how have things been for you since everything shut down in Texas?
Oh boy. It's kind of weird not being able to just, like, go outside the house yeah. without being, like, scared. And I also had, like, some plans to come back and visit you guys, because
yeah.
I just don't miss you guys so much. But now, like, I'm, like, unsure if those plans are going to be able to, like, you know, pull through. Because, I mean, hopefully this corona stuff goes by quickly.
Yeah. I guess one thing that's funny is, like, everyone knows now that you used to live in my old house, but did you know that before we moved here the first time, we lived in Houston, Texas?
Oh, really? I didn't know that.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
And there's a bit of a delay between the broadcast and you talking to me, but I would like to open this up for anyone in the YouTube chat to ask any questions for Connor. See what happens.
I miss everyone so much. Especially you, Kevin, man. You're just like, your talent is so crazy, amazing. Like, that video, like, I don't know how to describe it. It was just, like, I didn't stop smiling the entire time.
So I'm just trying to look at the YouTube chat right now. While I'm trying to figure this out, what was your, like, response to when I showed the first video I'd ever made?
Oh, that's really funny. Like, it's like, I knew you where you were at because, you know, I lived there for 5 years. So it was funny to see, like, the place again, but also it was just, like, funny to see, like, you with all those other kids. I thought it was really cute, and it was really funny.
Thank you. So I'm getting a lot of comments about the team missing you, in the chat.
Yeah, I miss them so much. It's like we moved to Texas for family, but it was like leaving family to be closer to family. You know, it's like leaving my big dance family, like, to go be closer to, you know, relatives, but definitely bittersweet, but I miss them all so much.
Okay, so I do have one question from Noemi. How hard has it been to go from Virginia to NDA to Texas in the span of around a week and a half?
Oh, boy. Well, I was in Virginia for like a month by myself without my family. I was staying with family friends so that I could be there for the month of practice leading up to nationals, so I didn't get behind and stuff like that. But so I pretty much had my entire life in two suitcases. From Virginia to NDA was it was pretty crazy. Like, it was like with all these practices and stuff, but it's like the morning of nationals, I was like, holy crap, it's already gone. It's like, it's already all over. And I'm like, so I definitely think your video, especially at nationals, helped me, like, remember all the moments that I, you know, wouldn't have immediately remembered. But from nationals to Texas was crazy, man. We were the day of parks. We were walking around all day. We were up at like 7, and I was up from 7 until like, when I landed here at like 10 o'clock the next day. So it was like 27 hours of being awake, but it was definitely worth spending those extra couple hours of not sleeping, but spending them with the team and getting to just like be with them for a little bit extra time, you know?
Okay. Is there anything else you would like to add?
Well, I just want to thank you again, Kevin. You're just, your talent and your finesse with videos and editing and all like the music and everything, it's just, it blows me away, Kevin. You're just like, you did an amazing job, and I love you guys, DHSDT watching, you know, I miss you guys, I love you guys so much, and hopefully I get to come back and visit you guys soon. And my mom is saying, or you guys can come here, but I'm just gonna go within 27, but all right, sorry, I'm not gonna keep talking.
Okay, well, thank you for calling.
All right, of course. Bye, Kevin.
Bye. Okay, so our next caller is Monique. Hello? I can't see you. Oh, there we go. Okay. So, what was your response to the video?
Oh my god, I literally loved it so much. Like, it's just so exciting to, like, finally, when my friends asked me, like, what do you guys do during, like, an eight-hour practice? Like, you guys really just, like, dance for 8 hours straight? And it was just, like, it's nice to have something to, like, be able to show them. And it's just so cool because the memories that you capture are things that I literally will be able to, like, show my kids one day. And it just makes me so excited. And I couldn't thank you enough for, like, putting these memories together. So
thank you. So, how have you been feeling since everything is shut down with COVID-19?
It's definitely a change. I'm trying to, like, still do stuff, and it's definitely weird going from, like, running 2 miles every day to, like, absolutely doing nothing.
Yeah.
But I've been trying to work out, you know, run every once in a while when I'm feeling it. But it's definitely harder when you don't have the whole team pushing you. So yeah, it's definitely different, but it's also really nice because I think that compared to any other sports team, we do work all year round, so it's not just like a few months here and there. But yeah, it's definitely nice to have a break, but it's also weird. So
yeah. And I also when I was driving back from Subway the other day, I saw you.
Oh no. Oh yeah. We were at the light.
Yeah.
I told my sister, I was literally just talking about your video, and I was telling her that it's going to come out Saturday at 5. I was so excited. Literally, this is the only thing that I've had to look forward to, like, over this break. I've been so bored, and I was so excited when this came out. Oh my god, I'm so excited. And I'm gonna post this on all my social media. I want all my friends to see it. I want everyone to see this video. I literally just can't wait. But I was telling her, I was like, yeah, it comes out Saturday at 5, and then I pull up to the light, and you're right there, and I was like, that he made it! It's so funny.
Well, is there anything else you'd like to add?
I just want to say hi to everyone. I miss you guys. I hope you guys are all doing good. And I'm definitely sad that we don't get to do some of the end of year things that we usually get to do. And I'm just really glad that we now, like, finally this video is out. And we all really appreciate all the hard work that you put into it. And it's just so memorable. It hits home. Just, like, watching all these memories that happened. And I was watching the video, and I was, like, getting nervous. And I was like, I did that. I know what happens. I don't know why I'm getting so nervous. But it's just, like, reliving through these memories. It's just, like, a little bit stressful, but it's just so heartwarming. And it's so exciting to have this, like, insane creation for literally the rest of my life. So I am so thankful for you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, thank you for calling in.
Of course. Have a good one.
You too. Okay, our next caller is Vivian. Hello? Hey, 1 second. The response to the video?
The video was so good. I was so happy to see it, and it really just made me feel like I was there again, and, like, seeing, like, how much fun we had, and made me, like, want to go back and see everyone and, like, relive those moments because it went by so fast. Yeah. But you did a really good job. Thank you. And you're so talented, and it was really good.
So how have you been doing since everything shut down?
Pretty good. Kind of bored sometimes, but I'm trying to stay active and, you know, like, still talk to some friends and hang out with my family. So I've been doing pretty good. How about you?
I've mostly been really bored.
Yeah.
The only thing I've had to do pretty much so far is edit this video, and I finished it on Monday. So this week I've had, like, aside from setting this up, nothing to do.
Yeah.
Next week we have, like, they're going to try to start giving us work, but they said it's like 30 minutes of work per class. So like I did the math.
Yeah.
Even if they decide to like combine A days and B days, it's still only about half of a regular school day's worth of work. It's 3.5 hours. So yeah. And I feel like everyone is just going to be like, get so far behind because of it.
Probably. Yeah. And all of our grades are going to be all messed up.
The nice thing though is all the SOLs are canceled. So
yeah, that is nice.
Is there anything else you'd like to add?
I just want to say that I miss the team so much, and going to practices and seeing everyone, like everyone like really makes my day, like, you know, just seeing everyone. And and good job on the video.
Thank you.
And we're all like, get to see those memories. Thank you.
Yeah, no problem. Thank you for calling in.
Thank you. Bye.
Bye. Okay. So our someone filled this out twice. All right, our next caller is Frankie. Okay, I think we're gonna move on. We're gonna move on to our next caller now, which is Noemi. Hello? Hi, are you calling from a phone or a laptop? Okay. Okay, so what was your reaction to the video?
I really liked it. I thought that it really showed how exactly we work, because like a lot of people before me said, a lot of people just assume that we just go on vacation for a week and call it like a day. But I think your video really brought in the two ideas that we kind of work while we play. So of course we're always working hard, but there's always some little like comedic moments in there where we're just like goofing around, and I think that really captures it well, because I think a lot of people just don't really see that, or they just think it's just fooling around 24/7. So I think it was a good mix.
How have you been doing since everything shut down?
Honestly, a little worried. At least for me, I have two elderly people living in my house, and I myself I'm a little susceptible to it. Like, I'm more inclined to get it. And if I do get it, it would be pretty bad for me. So it's just been a little worrying. Like, should I really go out to get groceries, or should I stay inside? Yeah. But aside from all of that, I've just been bored, and like, I swear to God, I'm going insane. How about you?
I've been pretty bored for the most part, other than editing the video and like setting this up. I haven't had a whole lot to do. I've been trying to go for like bike rides a lot, at least.
Yeah. Oh, me too. It's a little sad though. Everything's so desolate. I'm like, God, this apocalypse. It's pretty
crazy.
The
weird thing is, in my neighborhood, at least Rivercrest, it seems like if anything, it's like more active than usual. Like we've seen like more people outside walking or like playing in their front yards with their kids.
Yeah, I've noticed that too in my backyard. Like sometimes I'm like playing on my Switch and then I look outside my window and I see like five families walking around. I'm like, when did you walk around before this? So now you decided to go out in the middle of a pandemic. Okay.
Is there anything else you'd like to add?
No, that I just miss everyone. Even though I am on the quieter side, I do definitely miss the noise. Yeah. The company, and I just really wish that everyone on the team is doing okay, even though we are going through kind of troubling times.
Okay, well, thank you for calling.
All right, thank you so much.
Okay, so our next caller is Aiden. Hello? Hello? Hi. I can see you now. Okay. So what was your response to the video?
I think if there was like a national competition for video making, you'd definitely take grand champion.
Thank you.
For sure. It's just like I watching the video for me, seeing like all the parts that was like I was in the background just makes me think how like everything just like goes over your head so quickly and how easy it is to like forget. So like to watch this video definitely like fills in some of the pieces I forgot and just makes like the experience more wholesome. Yeah. For sure.
So how have you been feeling since the, like, everything shut down?
I guess it has its pros and cons. It's all about how you think about it. I mean, it's definitely weird to go from, like, 100% every single day to, like, waking up at, like, 11 in the morning and then, like, leisurely doing nothing throughout the day. I mean, but, I have been taking a lot of bike rides because I like to bike, so that's a lot of fun to do.
Mm-hmm. Is there anything else you'd like to add?
I just want to say, like, thank you so much. Like, this is definitely, it's, like, crazy. I never knew, like, that you could, like, well, I always knew you were so talented. It's just, like, just see it all. It's just crazy that you're able to do that. And I'm, like, amazed every single time you do it.
Thank you.
I just want to say I miss everyone. Like, all I want to do is go to practice and goof off and do whatever.
Oh, well, thank you for calling.
Yeah, that's it. All right, thank you.
Okay, our next caller is Crystal. Hello? Hi.
Okay, is this better?
Yeah. So what was your response to the video?
I'm sorry, what? It's kind of hard to hear.
So what was your response to the video?
It was amazing. I loved it so much.
Thank you.
Towards the end, I started tearing up with the whole seniors and just the end of it.
Yeah.
It was great.
So how have you been doing since everything shut down?
Been kind of weird. Usually, like, I'm on the schedule, you know, with school, dance, and coming home, but now I just don't know what to do with my life. It's kind of weird.
Yeah. Is there anything else you'd like to add?
Just thank you for everything you've done for the team, and I miss everyone out there watching. Hopefully you guys are safe, and that's it.
Okay, thank you for calling.
Yep.
Okay. Our next caller is Sarah. Hello? Hi. I can't see you.
Okay. Oh, wait. Now?
Yeah.
Is that good?
Okay. One second. I'm, adjusting it on my end. So what was your response to the video?
I love the video. It was honestly so sorry.
It's okay.
It was honestly like so heartwarming to watch it. Having like it just felt like I was there again, and sorry, my friends are talking to me.
It's okay.
But yeah, it was just amazing. It was so good. Thank you so much for it. But yeah.
So how have you been doing with everything being shut down?
I've honestly been pretty bored, not gonna lie. I've recently just watched all of the Marvel movies.
Oh, yeah.
Because, you know, just because I've been doing some homework, just eating a lot. That's pretty much it.
So how does it feel? Like, I think you're the first senior who's called in, like, basically the end of high school.
Sorry, wait, can you repeat that question?
Yeah, so I guess you're the first senior who's called in. How does it feel like with this basically being like the end of high school?
It's honestly really sad. When I heard about like everything like shutting down, I was like really upset because I was looking forward to like lock-in, pep rally, like everything was like my last lock-in, all that stuff. And like, it was just like really upsetting because I was looking forward to graduation also. And since I won't be able to get that either, it's like upsetting.
Yeah.
And yeah. But I'm just like excited to see the team next year and how everybody's going to be. I will be visiting a lot. So hopefully they don't get tired of me just yet.
Yeah. Is there anything else you'd like to add?
Just thank you so much for the video. I can now have...
Thank you, Pepe!
Okay. You're welcome.
Now I have, like, something I can, like, watch 24/7. I probably won't stop watching it for a while. And just, I miss you guys so much, everyone that's watching, and I love you. And, yeah.
All right, well, thank you for calling it.
Thank you, Kevin.
Bye. Okay. So our final three callers are Alex, Coral, and Lily in that order. Okay. Hello?
Final three callers are Alex.
Mute the stream real quick.
Lily in that order.
Thank you. Okay, so what was your response to the video?
I got extremely emotional during it just because I'm an extremely emotional person. As you guys all saw at Nationals, I cried so much at Nationals. But oh my God, it was so good, Kevin.
Thank
the video
you.
Was so good. And I'm just so happy that I'm going to be able to have that, and I'm able to continuously watch like my last nationals and all the other like competitions from this year. So I want to thank you so much for doing that.
Yeah, I had a lot of fun with the team at nationals. So I guess how have things been for you, especially with like, you know, this being like senior year and everything?
It's been extremely difficult. When I heard about first off, I got back from nationals. I was already kind of starting to get like, I was already a little hoarse and stuff from all the screaming, but it progressed to something worse. I'm completely better now. So for all you guys are wondering, I'm fine. And with all the corona stuff, I was extremely worried that something was going to happen. But nothing happened. I got checked. I'm fine.
Oh, okay.
So I'm perfectly healthy now, but I wasn't going to be able to go back to school. And so I was upset because I never got to say goodbye.
Yeah.
Anyone. And it was a very abrupt stop to everything because we were going from practice for like the entire month leading up to nationals. The nationals was like, go. And then it's like, stop.
Yeah.
So that was extremely difficult. I cried a bit because I won't be able to experience my last lock-in, my last pep rally, spirit week, prom, all the senior stuff that I wish I could.
Yeah.
I think I'm just trying to make the best of things. Family's trying not to get on our nerves, trying to do our best, checking in on everyone. So, yeah.
Well, is there anything else you'd like to add?
Coaches, I want to thank you for an amazing 4 years on the dance team. I promised I wouldn't cry.
It's okay.
I want to, Dominion, it's been an honor dancing with you guys for 4 years, and I know you guys are going to do amazing next year. I promise to come visit as much as I can, but I love you all and I miss you so much, and it's been an honor.
Okay, well, thank you for calling in.
All right, thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
Okay, our next caller is Coral. Okay, I'm just gonna search it. There we go. Hi, are you calling from a laptop? Hello? I can't hear you. Is your microphone muted? I still can't hear you. No sound still.
Can you hear me now?
Yeah, now I can hear you.
Okay, cool.
Okay. So what was your response to the video?
Kevin, you're so talented. Oh my gosh.
Thank you.
Holy crap. You're so talented. So it really, like everyone said, captured the moment. I felt like I was there again, because that's, like, your video was the vision of, like, how I felt and, like, everything like that. And it felt nice. Yeah.
So how have you been doing since everything has shut down?
I have been chilling, honestly. I've been catching up with family. I've been catching up on my TV shows that I have not watched. And the other... I'm supposed to stay inside, but, like, it was pretty fun.
Is there anything else you'd like to add?
I miss everyone. Yeah, I love everyone. And, yeah, Kevin, you're so talented. Thank you. Yeah.
Okay, well, thank you for calling.
Thank you.
Okay, so our final caller is Lily. Okay, this is where things start to make less sense. Hello? Hi.
How are you?
Good, how are you?
I'm good. I love the video so much.
Thank you.
I was obsessed with it. We were all in awe. Thank you so much.
So I guess how have you been feeling since everything is shut down?
What? Sorry, I kind of got McDonald's Wi-Fi here, so.
Oh, okay. So how have you been feeling since everything shut down?
Got you. Yeah. That's all I got. I'm sorry. It was amazing. Seriously, it went by so fast, though.
Yeah.
I mean, it seemed like it was like, what, 5 days? It went by in like 5 minutes.
Yeah.
I am. And I miss you guys all a lot. So much. I want everything to go back to normal, and I pray it does soon. Hopefully. So. Just gotta, you know, hang in there, and everything's gonna be okay.
Yeah.
Trust. But yeah.
Is there anything you'd like to add?
No, just that. Yeah, that's it. That's it.
Okay. Thank you for calling.
Bye-bye.
Okay, well, that is it for our live broadcast. Thank you to all our callers for joining us on our live broadcast. I'd just like to end by saying that I miss the entire team very much. I had so much fun, at Nationals, and to echo what so many of the callers said, it is really tough going from being together for like 70, 96 hours straight, something like that, to not seeing anyone at all, except for like, I video chatted with one person once on Snapchat, and that was it. So I hope everyone is doing well, and I hope we get out of this sooner rather than later. Thank you for watching, and let's roll the trailer just one more time for fun.